I want to get into a quick question. I think this is a great one for week one. Name your favorite buy low player that you are targeting in trades this week. Because if there's ever a time to take advantage of a tilting fantasy football owner, it would be week one when all their hopes and dreams were smashed by subpar performances by their superstars. Am I right?
You are correct. And there was a lot of superstars that had really rough week one.
Yeah, and I'll answer with my favorites. And I will actually say all of the Buccaneers. So Mike Evans, Chris Godwin, O.J. Howard, I would be targeting all three of them. And Jameis Winston was so difficult to look at with your eyeballs that the hideous Jameis will distort the real fantasy outcomes for this team and for what Bruce Arians will be able to accomplish with this downfield offense. Mike Evans was sick. Chris Godwin salvaged his game with a touchdown. O.J. Howard, some drops, some lower snap count than I would have hoped. So I think there is a better future for fantasy. Now, if you're the Buccaneers and you're hoping for a Super Bowl title, I'm not enthusiastic about Jameis. But for fantasy purposes, I would be targeting all the Bucks.
Yeah, I completely agree. I think that Evans is a fantastic target coming off of that performance. The guy I want to throw out, it wasn't horrific for Juju Smith-Schuster. He still had, you know, an okay day considering what happened to the Pittsburgh Steelers. But people were hoping for a lot from Juju, and it just the Patriots, this is what they do. Jason, you were talking about this last week before the game happened that you love Juju, but week one is definitely a concern against Uncle Bill and the Patriots because they always shut down number one options. Just look what they've done in the past to number one guys like Tyreek Hill, DeAndre Hopkins, like big name wide receivers play against the Patriots and they get shut down. This is just what happens. So I'm still in on Juju Smith-Schuster and I'm still in on the Steelers offense.
Yeah, and for me it's very similar is James Conner because the Pittsburgh Steelers were down 20-0 in the blink of an eye. The worst possible game script for James Conner. And, you know, the Patriots, man, did they look unfathomably good.
They look like it's impossible to beat them.
I wanted to ask you, Andy, you have seen the future, and you said that the Philadelphia Eagles win the Super Bowl.
Correct.
But how do you feel about that now after seeing the
Patriots? Well, look, I posted 18-0 for the Patriots. I didn't post 19-0.
Oh.
So, yes, I don't think it'll be the Giants breaking up that perfect season, but Philadelphia, same division. I'm cool with that.
Very nice.
But no, they look great. And then you've got Uncle Bill equivocating on whether Antonio Brown's going to play for them this week.
Oh, yeah.
Which is a real possibility. I mean, it's possible they don't feel the need.
They don't need him this week.
They may bench a couple extra other guys just for safety.
We're going to play with nine guys.
Brady, sit this one out. The reality is every single league out there has that owner that tilts week one. We have them in our league. And you have to go and trade for whoever did not do well this week. Trade away whoever did well. You know what I mean? Like, just find the guys that, like, Mike Evans is a perfect example. Because if they're not paying attention, they don't know about the illness. They don't know about the snap counts.
Well, and you're not trying. What you're trying to do is say, I don't know. Here's a good example. I obviously believe in the Colts offense. I believe in T.Y. Hilton. T.Y. Hilton scored twice this week. You know, he's on average, what, a 6-7 touchdown a year guy?
Right.
He scored twice this week. If you can go flip T.Y. Hilton for Mike Evans.
Sure.
That's the recipe. The super high. You're not going to steal Mike Evans for Hollywood Brown or somebody. You're not going to steal him for a 1 week no name, but for T.Y. Hilton, a big name, that's a possibility. I almost put James Conner in as my buy low, even though I'm not a believer in the Steelers long term. His performance this week, there's a lot of brighter days ahead for James Conner. He's just too – look, you can't give Dazi Moncrief 10 targets. You need to
exactly
use Juju and you need to use Conner. And whether more teams are capable of taking those guys away like Bill Belichick, I doubt it. I doubt it. And so just utilization-wise, it makes sense.
Hey, guess what? Click that subscribe button, and I might send you something in the mail. Maybe. You should do it.